hyperspectral and multispectral imaging application for remote sensing. What is spectral imaging? A spectral image is an image consists of several spectral bands. Number of spectral bands of a multispectral image can vary from 3 to 10. A hyperspectral image is an image consists of continuum spectral bands. Advantages of using an imaging system are utilized in remote sensing, chemical-free, environment-friendly, human-independent, automation and economical. An in-house built multispectral imaging system is used to capture the images. The system consists of an aluminium integrating hemisphere, STM32 discovery board and a monochrome camera with the facility of capturing images consisting of 9 discrete spectral bands in the range of ultraviolet to near infrared.
Here, multispectral imaging based approaches have been taken to analyze contamination on high voltage insulators and food quality analysis. Furthermore, we have tried to solve hyperspectral unmixing problem. Let us now focus on identifying contamination on high voltage insulators. Common contaminants found on high voltage insulators are dust, algae, salt, and industrial contaminants. Here we focus on identifying algae and salt contamination. These contaminants result in an increase in the conductivity causing flashover. To identify algae contamination, a Bhattacharya distance-based approach was taken. After obtaining algae samples from 33 kV insulators from different climatic zones, they were cultivated, followed by placing algae strips with different dimensions on an insulator substrate to capture the multispectral images. Bhattacharya distance measures the statistical similarity between two Gaussian distributions, a reference and a sample. To create the reference distribution, a pixel window containing pure algae was extracted. The pixel intensity distribution of extracted window was a Gaussian distribution. To identify algae affected areas, 5x5 superpixels of image were considered. After obtaining pixel intensity distribution for each superpixel, algae patch was identified by calculating Bhattacharya distance between reference distribution and distribution of each superpixel window.
Now let's move on to a different application area. Here I will focus on the fish quality analysis. We conducted this research as per a request from Nara, Sri Lanka, because quality control plays a vital role in export industry and current conducted methodology of quality assurance is not reliable. Therefore, a reliable and an efficient method is on demand. Now, I will discuss our approach. Initially, multispectral images of different fish samples were obtained. Then, they were pre-processed by some algorithms. Thereafter, we fed those pre-processed data to several classification algorithms. Eventually, it will produce fish quality grades ranging from A+ to C-. Now, I am going to discuss the results of this analysis. We got the maximum classification accuracy by a convolutional neural network which was built by us. Fish quality grade classification accuracies are 93%, 84% and 78% for tuna, salia and hurulna respectively.
Next, we focused on hyperspectral imaging applications for remote sensing. Unmixing problem is the main application we focus under the hyperspectral unmixing for remote sensing. Hyperspectral unmixing is the process of separating mixed pixel spectra into a collection of pure spectral signatures called N-members and their abundance maps. Our first approach on hyperspectral unmixing is non-negative matrix factorization. First, pre-process the image data cube by applying principal component analysis to convert 3D dataset to 2D dataset. Then, non-negative matrix factorization was applied to the pre-processed dataset and original dataset separated to two positive WNH matrices, which gives N members and abundances. Finally, validation was done by taking mean square error with the ground. As conventional NMF is not unique, constraints are used to improve the uniqueness. Therefore, we use a statistical parameter kurtosis-based constraint which promotes statistical independence among N members. So smoothing is done to eliminate the anomalous spikes of end members. The utilization of smoothing matrix in NMF is shown in the following figure. This is the equation typically used for smoothing matrix, where theta is an optimizable parameter and k is number of end members. After doing several trials with the smoothing matrices, an improved result was obtained. The green color strip was given the best result we obtained with divergence method diagonal smoothing matrix at theta equals 0.5. These are the abundances and end members obtained by KBS NMF with the improved diagonal smoothing matrix. The figure shown in the left is abundance map. In the abundance map, region shown in dark blue color is the identified end member placement.